A woman avoids arrest after hitting a child and causing a significant injury. Let's put up the picture of the child, okay? You see that? That's child abuse. That's what that is. UK police have been criticized for not prosecuting a white woman who hit an autistic 12-year-old black child on the forehead with a paddle so forcefully he needed to go to the hospital for the deep cut. Let's keep his picture up, okay? The gash on his head had to be glued together, and now he has been left with scar tissue and a lump on his forehead. His father said, and I quote, "He was so upset. I brought him up here to be brave, so he tried to take it on the chin. He's trying to get on with his day-to-day life, but he's affected." The incident took place at Conum River Park on March 26th when Antoine met a group of friends for a birthday party. While the woman was arrested following the incident, an April 14th letter from Avon and Somerset police arrived telling the family basically the case has been resolved. I'm writing you in reference to the incident of the assault of your son, Antoine. The case has been reviewed, and unfortunately, the decision has been made to take no further action in this case. The main reason for this is that during the interview, the suspect raised a possibility for self-defense. What? A possibility of self-defense. Okay? That's all it took. White woman physically abuses a child that's 12 years of age, autistic. Oh, is there a possibility here that you were in fear for your life? Oh, well, that does it then. We have to drop all charges here. All right, so sorry. Hands are tied. White woman said, possibly it was self-defense. What can we do? The case is an expression once again of the globalization of racism. Relatives of the young Antoine and campaigners questioned why the woman clashed with Antoine rather than white friends he was with, and are asking whether race played a part in the decision not to press charges. The force has since said it has initiated a review of the case. So now they're looking at the case a second time. Okay? The boy's father, Mr. Forrest, who is of mixed race, said, and I quote, "If it was me that had hit a white child, I would be in jail right now. I was devastated when I got the letter from the police saying they were taking no further action. I had to tell Antoine she was getting away with it." Forrest claimed some of the children, but not Antoine, were throwing mud balls at passing boats, including one being paddled by the woman who works for a car dealership. What followed allegedly involved some pushing and shouting and ended up with Antoine being struck by the woman with a paddle. And as Forrest said, my son was standing there, blood pouring down his face. Remember, this is an autistic 12-year-old child. Forrest was called and asked the woman what happened. He claimed that she said she had seen red and didn't mean it. The police arrived and arrested the woman. They told me she had admitted it. And then later the police found an excuse to exonerate her without a trial. All right. An outcry followed after the family posted the image of his wound. In a statement, Avon and Somerset police said, "The incident was taken seriously and a woman was arrested and interviewed. It added a realistic prospect of a conviction was not made out from the available evidence following the investigation. Since becoming aware of the injured boy's family's concerns through social media, officers have been in touch with them and initiated a review." What did this? Not their sense of right, not their sense of policy and protocol, not their sense of public good, but the fact that it went viral on social media. Now, now we've called them because we saw what happened on Facebook. So we've called them now. And because of that post that went viral, we have initiated another review of this case. All right. So as I say often, the criminal justice system, not just in America, The criminal justice system everywhere needs to be broken. It's actually working the way it was designed to work. And you literally have a situation where a woman admitted to physically abusing a 12-year-old black autistic child, admitted it, gets arrested for it, and doesn't even have to go through the judiciary to be adjudicated. She just gets a letter from some high up at the police department who says, you can go. Possibly it was self-defense, right? Yeah, you can go home.